My name is Toni Branner. I live in Charlotte, North Carolina. I'm an exercise physiologist, a wellness consultant, a plant-based lifestyle coach, and I've been working in the prevention, fitness, nutrition field for almost 40 years now. And I still wake up excited every single morning. And I'm so honored that I've been asked to share a little bit with you today about prevention at the cellular level and things that we can do on a daily basis to move us forward in our journey toward optimal health. So I'm going to share my screen with you today to make it a little more fun and exciting. Today, we're talking about resiliency, and resiliency is so important in today's world because we're bombarded from all directions with stressful things, you know, and we're going to talk a little bit about how we can protect our health, even though we maybe can't get rid of all the stress. What can we do to take a little more control over that? I became known as the crazy plant lady early in my career. And by the time we're finished tonight, I think you'll know why. Absolutely. This is a photo of my family. I love starting with this because my passion is that my kids and your kids and your neighbors and your community are not going to experience the diseases that we see in our clients. My husband's a doctor, that's him in the middle. And every day he sees people losing their vision, you know, to things like macular degeneration and cataracts and glaucoma. And, you know, it's just so important that we start to create a legacy from the very youngest to the very oldest. This is my granddaughter with my mom. And we're learning more and more that it's the simple things that can create vibrancy in life and energy to really fulfill your mission and why you were put on this earth to begin with. So inspiring healthy living around the world is what our community is all about. And I could just read you a bunch of statistics, but that wouldn't be very fun, right? And we know that kind of our world is headed in the wrong direction. And it is going to take an army. It is going to take a village to start to turn that around. And we'd love for you to be a part of the solution. So if there's something that you hear in this workshop today that you think might help somebody else, we hope that you'll share it. The one statistic that I really like to share, because sometimes we don't think about it, is the bottom one that comes from Dr. Katz at Yale University. Our children are more harmed by poor diet than by exposure to drugs, alcohol, and tobacco combined. That is pretty crazy. We wouldn't think of putting our children in the car without a seatbelt or a car seat. And yet sometimes day after day, we feed them food that maybe is not quite as nourishing as it should be. Some of it's not our fault. Our world is more toxic. Our water is more contaminated. Our air is more polluted. We're genetically modifying food. We're radiating food. We're adding thousands of additives that our bodies don't even recognize. And, you know, our food sometimes spends a couple of weeks on a truck getting to our grocery store and loses a lot of nutrition before we actually eat it. And then the food that our grandparents ate, studies show, had a lot more nutrition than the same broccoli that we're eating today. And so, again, it's not really fair, but it is the facts are the facts. And so we're going to help you kind of come up with some solutions and resources to overcome those things. This is Nick the Knight. He's my little guy that goes with me into schools and speaking with children and adults. And we're going to talk a little bit about this resilience situation. There's all kinds of resilience: mental, emotional, social, physical, spiritual resilience. And I'm going to make the case that some very simple changes that you can do in your life can really improve your resilience in all of these areas, making your brain stronger, right? Having a positive outlook, having the energy to connect with others, and of course, making your body stronger and helping your body become healthier at the cellular level. Wouldn't it be amazing if we could prevent disease at the cellular level way before anyone experienced the heartache of a diagnosis? So you're going to know most of these already. Of course, you need to stay hydrated. Many adults and children are chronically dehydrated. Just look in the toilet every time you go, and your urine should be clear to lightly straw colored. Super simple. Teach your kids that. Keep it clear. Quality of sleep and quantity of sleep. Very, very important. And just a few tips. Keep your room completely dark. Try to avoid screen time a couple of hours before you go to sleep. Maybe try to limit caffeine and alcohol after, you know, a certain period of time, especially because that can disrupt your sleep. And the big one is try to eat earlier in the evening, because if you go to bed after a very heavy meal, your body has to spend all night digesting, and you're not really using that time to detox and regenerate, which is really the amazing part about sleep. Of course, exercise is so important on all fronts, not just physical, but we have many research studies showing the benefits of exercise on mental health. And so every day, do something, walk, you know, swim, cycle, find some ways to add resistance. We have many, many resources that we can offer you to find something that will fit into your busy lifestyle. Sometimes people don't really think about nature as a foundational health habit, but getting out into the sunshine, a lot of great things happen. You make your own vitamin D, of course, which is the very best way to get your vitamin D, but also looking at the sun helps you set your circadian rhythm. So going out first thing in the morning is going to be beneficial for your sleep rhythms, for your metabolism. And we also pick up healthy microbes from the outdoors, which are going to be a part of our microbiome, which we'll talk about in a moment. Getting outside can also be a great way to grow your own food or grow your own flowers. You're moving around, you're active, and you're accomplishing all of those things by being outdoors. When we can start to grow our food closer to us, we're going to overcome a lot of those challenges about nutritional density in our food. What about stress management? Things like writing in a gratitude journal, actually writing in a journal, meditation, deep breathing, counseling, communication skills, all of those things have been shown through research to reduce the effects of a stressful situation on your health. So why is it that two people can be experiencing the same issues in their life and one gets sick and one doesn't? And when we study that, we see that these foundational health habits are what are protecting you. We may also want to look at toxins in our home, maybe our cleaning products, our beauty products. Some of them are invisible, which is really scary, like molds and funguses that can be in your house and affect your health. Maybe EMF and EMR radiation that comes from cellular technology, Bluetooth technology, even power lines outside of your house. Sometimes we're not aware of those things, but by playing detective, we can kind of limit them the best that we can. One big tip I have is to try to get all the technology out of your bedroom at night. So at least while you're sleeping, you have a rest from that radiation that is coming from all of those devices. So now, what do we have? We've created an armor around our health by practicing these foundational health habits. And studies show now the stress can't get in. It's still there. We can't get rid of all of it, but it's not making you sick. And I saved my favorite one for last, and that is nutrition. Studies show that when people consume a lot of whole food, plant-based additions to their diet, it reduces the effects of stress on their health. So let's dive into that a little deeper. Let's focus on fruits and vegetables. This is a graph from a very large study. And along the bottom, you see different countries. The green on the graph represents the average consumption of plant food in those countries. Fruits, vegetables, nuts, seeds, whole grains, and beans. The red on the graph represents deaths from heart disease and cancer. Do you notice anything, right? Yikes, they're indirectly proportional. So as you eat more plants, you're more protected. And the graph looks actually very similar for other diseases like diabetes and Alzheimer's and Parkinson's and even allergies. So plants are wonderful. They're so protective. Another way we have studied this is to look at areas of the world called the blue zones. The blue zones were identified because people in those areas naturally live to be older, 90, 95, 100, and they tend to just die in their sleep instead of having this period of debilitation and nursing home care and multiple medications and hospitalizations. And when we look at what they do, it's actually very simple. They move a lot. They're active. They stay mentally engaged in their communities and their families. They don't smoke and they eat mostly plants. Almost all of them eat about 95% of their calories from plant foods. Animal foods and dairy may be served just for condiments or maybe for special celebrations. So this is something that we have seen through the research that really reinforces what we know about a whole food plant-based diet. Now, is this for everyone? Pretty much. I know a lot of us read the magazines and the celebrity diets, and you know, there's one diet for this and one diet for that. But when we look at who lives the longest and who lives the healthiest, to me, those are the most important things. It's the people who eat the most plants, absolutely. And we want to show you that it can be delicious, it can be simple, it can be affordable. Absolutely amazing. And we do have some people who say, oh, I eat a lot of plants, but maybe it's potato chips. So we want to kind of make the difference here that we want nutrient dense foods. Now, there are some foods called transitional foods, which are like the plant-based burgers that you can eat and the fake chicken and all those things. And those are okay if they help you kind of make that transition. There's some actually pretty amazing plant-based cheeses now. And dairy is one of the more inflammatory foods. So the more you could substitute and find some transitional foods, that could be amazing. I'm a scientist. My background is biology, exercise physiology, nutrition. And so I love to share just a tiny bit of the science behind what plants do in our body, because what I find with my clients is once they understand it, then they intrinsically start to choose healthier options all on their own without anyone coercing them, right? Because we don't want anyone telling us what to eat. We want to naturally choose the health-giving foods. So the first one is inflammation. We call systemic inflammation. That means inflammation throughout your entire body. And we know within a couple of weeks of eating a mostly plant-based diet and adding more fruits and vegetables to your diet, your inflammation decreases. This becomes especially important. I work with Olympic level athletes, collegiate athletes, and this becomes super important for anyone who exercises and also people who have arthritis and joint issues. The more plants you can eat, the more it's going to lower that inflammation in your body. What about genetics? You know, I know some of you may have diseases that run in your family. I have a lot in my family, but through the study of epigenetics, or some people call it nutrigenomics, we've learned that even though you're born with a certain genetic makeup, almost every one of your genes has a switch. And with your health choices, especially nutrition, you can turn on the good genes and turn off the bad genes. And this is so hopeful because it means we're not just doomed if we were born with certain genes. We actually can take more control of that than we once thought. Another area that is really exciting is the study of your microbiome. Now, we have 4 to 7 pounds of bacteria living in us and on us. Kind of creepy, right? They live on our skin, they live in our mouth, in our nose, but mostly in our gut. And these little guys, there's good guys and bad guys in there. And the good guys are especially important for determining our immune system, our metabolism, and even our happiness. 90 to 95% of the serotonin that is important in our body is made in our gut. And the brain and the gut were made from the same embryonic tissue, and they are totally dependent on each other. So happiness, prevention of depression and anxiety, focus, attention, all of those things are related to the health of our gut. Well, guess what the good guys eat in our gut? I know you're going to be amazed. Plants. In particular, they eat plant fibers, which we call resistant starches. And we used to think, you know, fiber is important because it just kind of speeds things through, if you get my drift, and get it out of your body. But now we know that fiber is actually the prebiotic that serves to feed those healthy gut bacteria. If we're eating too much sugar and donuts and sodas and alcohol and animal foods, that's what the bad guys like, and they'll crowd out the good guys, which can lead to things like leaky gut syndrome and all kinds of issues, even issues that you don't really think have to do with your gut, things like ALS and lupus and things like that. We want to feed those good guys lots of fruits and vegetables. The number one predictor of the health of your gut biome is the diversity of plants that you consume. In other words, the variety of plants that you consume, because every color has different types of antioxidants and fiber. My research in graduate school was in the area of oxidative stress. Oxidative stress happens when you breathe oxygen. That's a good thing. Don't stop breathing. You create energy called ATP. And that's great, but there's some leftovers. And the leftovers are these little molecules called free radicals. And think of them like little hot BBs. They're kind of bouncing around in your body, causing damage to your skin, leading to wrinkling, to your retina, leading to macular degeneration. They can even cause mutations, and mutations can lead, you know, to terrible issues in your body. So I think we're gonna need some superheroes, right? Well, guess what? The superheroes are called antioxidants. And everyone's heard that word before, but most people don't know what they do. They actually donate an electron to the free radical and neutralize it so it can't harm you anymore. It's super, super cool, right? And every color of fruit and vegetable has different antioxidants that do different things in your body. So when you cut open an apple, right, the oxygen hits it, then what happens? It turns brown. It's deteriorating. That's kind of what happens to your cells if you have too much oxidative stress. And that can come from exercise, flying in airplanes, pollution, x-rays, you know, so many different ways we're just bombarded with this oxidative stress. But what happens if you squeeze a lemon on the apple? It is protected because lemons have thousands of antioxidants, live enzymes, vitamins, and minerals. So eat your fruits and vegetables. They're protecting you. Imagine those little free radicals just getting zapped in there, the more fruits and vegetables that you eat. What about your immune system? Some people have an immune system that's overactive, where their own body's kind of attacking themselves, right? That's called an autoimmune disease. And now there's hundreds of them, which is not okay. And then there's some people who have an immune system that's just not working very well. So they're catching many colds and flus and viruses and strep throat and mono. So we want to bring that into balance. And we do that. One of the ways is eating a lot of plants. And studies have shown that those are going to start to actually change our immune cells, like our natural killer cells and our T cells and our B cells. This isn't as quick as lowering inflammation. So you have to be consistent. You have to get those plants into your body on a daily basis. What about your brain? We're learning more and more that plants actually protect your brain and can reduce your risk of things that I know I dread, things like Alzheimer's. A couple just of the little tips that we know from the research is limiting saturated fats, which come from animal foods like dairy and meat, and limiting trans fats, which come from processed foods, eating a lot more plants of every variety and upping that vitamin E that comes from real food, things like seeds, nuts and seeds, and dark greens. And this is a quote that is really my favorite, coming from the crazy plant lady. The news isn't that fruits and vegetables are good for you. It's that they're so good for you, they could save your life. And how much do you need to eat? How many servings do you need to eat? Nobody really knows. It depends on how dense the nutrition is. It depends on a lot of things. So what I do with my clients is, instead of talking about servings, we talk about variety, right? How many colors can you get into your diet every day? In your smoothie, in your fruit bowl, in your salad bowl, in your stir fry, right? How many colors? And eating the rainbow is a great way to talk to your children about this. And that doesn't mean M&Ms and Skittles. That means actual colors of real plants, getting them into your body. That will also serve your microbiome, because every color has different types of fiber. So again, everyone's going to be happy if you're getting all of those colors into your body every day. And unfortunately, vitamins have not been found, isolated vitamins, to be able to do the same thing as whole food in your physiology. An apple has thousands of antioxidants, live enzymes, vitamins, minerals, and they're all put in there in the perfect synergy, the perfect proportion to protect you. And that's what you have to remember about whole food, is it was put on earth. Mother Nature put it here for a reason, so that it can protect us. And when we try to make up our own formula, sometimes it can cause more harm than good, right? So our community is offering this workshop today because we want to partner with you. We want to link arms with you. We want to be there with you as you move in the direction of optimal health. So we're going to share with you some solutions and resources to help you eat more fruits and vegetables and to help you consistently establish those healthy habits. So reach out to the person who invited you, because they can send you an amazing virtual swag bag of recipe books and challenges for children and all kinds of wonderful things. We're also going to help you, like, what do I do with all this stuff I got at the farmer's market, right? We get kind of overexcited. We buy a whole bunch of stuff and then we bring it home and put it in the fridge, and it a lot of times goes bad because we don't really know what to do with it. We're going to help you with smoothie recipes, wonderful breakfast recipes that have, you know, chia pudding and overnight oats and all kinds of flavors. And what about toast, you know, avocado toast, banana and peanut butter toast, veggie toast? Wouldn't that be an amazing breakfast, right? And then if you prep your food in just like an hour a week, you cook a big pot of grains, you roast some veggies, you cut up all your fresh veggies and wash them and put them in clear glass containers so that you can easily see them when you open the fridge, right? You're not going to forget about them. You can do things like all kinds of different flavors of bowls, salad in a jar, burrito in a jar. You could pretty much have the food prepared for your lunches and dinners for the entire week. And we'll actually partner with you and show you how to do that. We'll show you how to layer the salads. We'll have a party at your house to show all your friends. We really want to be a part of the solution. These are some simple veggie wraps, but wow, talk about eating the rainbow, right? What about packing healthy lunches? Sometimes it's hard, you know, and your school has rules, and, you know, we'll help you with ideas for that as well. A lot of times kids like things to not touch. So remember the bowls I just showed you. What you do is you deconstruct the bowl for your child. So you have one section with rice or, you know, quinoa, and you have another section with the cut up veggies and another section with the roasted veggies, right? And maybe a dipping sauce that you've made from plants. We can even show you like nacho cheese sauce made from plants. It's delicious, all kinds of wonderful things. What about when you have to take a meal to another family, you know, that's going through a stressful situation? Wouldn't it be wonderful to have some wonderful recipes? What about snacks? You know, we have learned a lot about picky children and picky adults. And sometimes if you leave the healthy food out for them, they're going to be more likely to consume it. What about parties? We can help you with that too. Believe it or not, this caprese salad is completely plant-based. We'll teach you the secret to that. This was a gender reveal party that I threw for my daughter, and we did the charcuterie boards, and that was 100% plant-based, even the cheeses, even the sauces and the dips, and everyone loved it. And again, you don't have to be perfect. You don't have to be the dreaded vegan word, right? If you say you're vegan, no one will ever invite you over for dinner ever again, right? Just kidding. But you know, we all need to be more plant-based. We need to move in that direction. And our community is never going to judge you. We're just going to help you make those steps. Some people are more one simple change at a time. And other people are like, let's do it tomorrow. Show me what to do. Give me a program. And we have that as well. What about sweet treats? We got you covered. We got all kinds of flavors of these fun energy balls. We have breakfast cookies. We have cookie dough that you can make. That's 100% plant-based, super fun. And this is one of my very favorite solutions that I found 27 years ago for my own family. I knew we were doing pretty well, but we weren't perfect. And I was worried about the food supply, and that I knew that the food supply wasn't what it needed to be, even if we were doing our best to eat a lot of fruits and vegetables. And I went to hear a talk at my local hospital, and I learned about plant powders or whole food concentrates. And I got really excited because my kids were 5 and 2. They had some health issues. My little boy would only eat white foods that didn't touch each other, anybody in that boat. And so I knew I needed just a little gap insurance to complement what I was already doing. And so Juice Plus is amazing. It's made from over 30 fruits and vegetables and berries. They partner with amazing family farms, and they let everything completely ripen with amazing soil conditions and all of that. Everything is certified non-GMO, right? They pick it and they flash freeze it right when it comes off the field to lock in the nutrition. It's a special process that is unbelievable. And then they pulverize it, right? So that it's ground down to small particles, but they leave in the seeds and the peels and the fiber, because remember, the microbiome needs that fiber, right? And then they dry it in a proprietary process that is at a super cold temperature to maintain the nutrition. And what do you get? These beautiful powders, astronaut food, or if you're old enough to remember Jetsons, Jetson food. And it didn't taste that great, so they decided to put it in a plant-based capsule to make it super simple and to protect the powders from oxygen degrading the nutrition. So that is absolutely amazing. And then some people were excited that they also developed a chewable for children, but also a lot of adults enjoy the chewables with the plant powders. They're very versatile. We can open the capsules and use them for people who don't want to swallow capsules, for babies. Absolutely amazing. So we have the fruit, the veggie, the berry, and the orange bottle are plant-based omega fatty acids. Omega fatty acids are called essential because you can't make them yourself. You have to eat them. And many, many people are deficient. If we're deficient, that can affect our heart health, our brain health, joints, skin, eyes, even things like focus, attention, and mood are affected to these fatty acids. So what's amazing is that many people have traditionally reached out and done fish oil, but fish oil has some issues. For me especially, it's the burpy fish taste and how much it harms the environment. But what if you skip the fish and went to the algae where the fish gets the omega to begin with? Wouldn't that be amazing? And what if you combined it with 5 other cold-pressed plant oils to give you the full spectrum of omega fatty acids? And that's what we have. Absolutely amazing. So I do all 4 blends every single morning, and I'm so grateful that I've had that in my life for 27 years. Another great solution are smoothies. The reason I believe smoothies are better than juicing is because when you juice, the sugar stays in and the fiber goes out. and remember why we need that fiber, right? But when you make a smoothie, you're keeping the fiber with the drink that you're making. And if you could add a plant-based smoothie mix to your smoothie, now you're really increasing the number of fruits and vegetables you get. So our Juice Plus Complete has chocolate and vanilla, a multitude of plant foods in there. It includes all the essential amino acids. So anyone who's worried about protein, you're covered there. 13 grams of protein, 8 grams of fiber, low glycemic index, gluten-free, dairy-free, non-GMO ingredients, all the things. I use it for breakfast. I use it as a glycogen replacement for myself and for my athletes. It's the perfect combination of carbohydrate to protein to reload your muscle cells, your brain, your liver, for the next workout that you're going to do. And you have a small window to do that, about 30 minutes to an hour after you complete your training or your workout. So this is the magic. You eat as healthy as you possibly can. You eat as many colors of the rainbow as you possibly can. And then you have these amazing solutions to bridge the gap so that every day you have peace of mind. You know that you're getting all of these colors into your body, all of these antioxidants. So three things to remember. One, Juice Plus plant powders are real food. They have a food nutrition label, not a supplement label. That's important to me. Two, they have outside quality control from an amazing organization called NSF. And then lastly, we have over 40 publications that show that Juice Plus powders work in your body in a very similar way to regular fruits and vegetables that have not been turned into a powder. Absolutely amazing. And these studies have been published in the top nutrition, exercise physiology, and medical journals that I've been reading since I was a professor at the University of North Carolina. So I'm just going to briefly highlight these. These are available. If you go to juiceplus.com, you can actually read the full studies. Remember those pesky free radicals, right? 11 studies showing Juice Plus plant powders reduce the effect of those free radicals on your body, that reduce the effect of oxidative stress. We also know that taking Juice Plus reduces DNA damage, which we measure with something called strand breaks. It actually is amazing in older people who need this so desperately, 66% reduction, and younger people, 44% reduction. That alone would be enough for me since this was my research. We have studies showing quality of life in stage 2 to stage 4 cancer patients that are in recovery with amazing results. The study was completed at MD Anderson Cancer Center. 2 published studies on healthier skin. So if you don't care about your insides, you just want to look good, we got you covered there. 2 published studies on healthier gums and 1 study on healthier recovery after wisdom tooth extraction, wound healing. Again, fruits and vegetables affect every aspect of your physiology. It doesn't really matter. What about your immune system? 4 published studies showing Juice Plus brings your immune system into balance after about 80 days. Again, not as quickly in a day. It's not, you know, it's not like something you can take and feel different in 30 minutes. This is actually changing your body at the cellular level. And one of our newest studies that was published has to do with brain health. And I love this because it shows that we are very connected. Our mental health is very connected to our physical health. And this is what the study showed: improved executive function, improved working memory, improved selective and sustained attention, and improved speed of processing. Absolutely blew my mind to see this and so excited. And again, I don't work with an athlete anymore unless I know they're protected at the cellular level. This is Dr. David Phillips, a medical doctor. He works with a lot of athletes. I work with a lot of athletes. And if we're going to push you, In your training, we need to know that you're protected at the cellular level from oxidative stress, from inflammation, from circulation issues, all of those things. So we know through the studies of Juice Plus and Fitness, it reduces oxidative stress, it reduces protein damage post-exercise, it decreases inflammation. The very best part is the price, because the families that I work with, most of them are on a budget. And if they were to go and buy 30 fruits and vegetables and try to chew them all, it would be pretty hard on their budget. But for a little over $3, you can take all four blends, the fruit, the veggie, the berry, and the omega, less than the cheapest cup of coffee at some of the coffee shops that I go into, right? And the smoothies are a little over $2. I know there aren't many snacks or healthy foods that you can get for $2 that are 100% plant-based that are going to give you those benefits. The last solution I want to share is an amazing tower garden. This is an aeroponic growing system with no dirt, no bending over, right? Sign me up. And it really has made a difference in our family. We grow two of them outdoors and one of them indoors. You can see the one on the left is a little sleeker. It's 24 inches. It can be grown indoors or outdoors, but most people grow it indoors. It has the grow lights. And on the right, we have the Tower Garden Flex, which again, you could add the lights to that and grow it indoors in the winter. But I love that this is such an environmentally smart decision. 98% less water, 90% less space, 30% more yield, grows three times faster than a traditional garden, but with the same amazing nutrition. And it's actually been researched at the University of Mississippi, where they compared the Tower Garden produce to produce grown in the very best soil conditions. So super, super exciting. This is my mom. I gave her one for Mother's Day 13 years ago, and she's still growing. It's the gift that keeps on giving. And we have a study out of Ohio State University showing that kids who participate in gardening are going to eat a lot more fruits and vegetables. We have a curriculum for children, for schools, so that you can actually teach your children how plants grow. And believe it or not, these are going to be worse pests than the squirrels and the birds, because they're going to come and steal the leaves off the Tower Garden so that they can eat them. Okay, so now you know Nick the Knight has created this armor around his health. And even though the world is stressful, even though you get a flat tire, even though your spouse hangs a toilet paper this way and you want it this way, whatever's going on in your life, practicing foundational health habits will start to fix the root issues and make you healthy from the inside out. So please reach out to the person invited you, get connected to our free resources, our recipe books, ask to be added to our private groups. We have Facebook, Instagram, private text. We'll find something that works for you. Maybe become a Juice Plus customer or a Tower Garden customer. We'll take great care of you. And I promise you will not regret your decision. I still am so grateful for making that decision 27 years ago for my family. Maybe you would sponsor a child. If you order Juice Plus, then you can sponsor your own child, a grandchild, a godchild, a neighbor in our Healthy Starts for Families program. And then maybe you want to help us volunteer, share with us some groups, maybe your church, maybe your place of work, a lunch and learn, so that we can get this information to more people. We need help. Or maybe you want to work with us, and that would be amazing too. I said at the beginning, it's going to take an army, it's going to take a village to turn our sick care world back into a well care world. We need people who love people, who want to be a part of a mission, who want to be a part of inspiring healthy living around the world. And we have a little bit of fun. The only requirement to help us is simply that you care about other people. There's no special background or shape or size that is required. So thank you again for joining me today. I've had a great time. I hope you have. Please feel free to share this information with somebody that you care about. And I hope you have the most wonderful day. Thank you so much.